All right. Well, I have to say we're winding down, but we do have a caller.
We do have a caller. All right, caller, you are online. Welcome to Geekin' Out with Skippy and the Dude. What's your name and what's your question?
Hi, my name is Christina, and I live in Sarasota.
Hello, Christina in Sarasota.
I have two questions. One is for Mr. Tatone.
Okay.
I was just wondering, where did he get the inspiration to write the movie Beautiful Noise?
As I said earlier, I had a story in mind, but I had an idea to incorporate my Neil Diamond background with regard to taking songs and writing from the inside out. Neil's got some great songs on that album, Beautiful Noise, that are really none of them major hits, but they all kind of, you know, lead to, and tell a story. And that wasn't the story. But anyway, so I was inspired by that particular album and the story Neil was trying to tell. And the first incarnation of the script was actually a Neil Diamond vehicle, but we knew we'd have trouble trying to license all those songs. And they loved the script, Neil's management, but they had a possible conflict with, they're trying to get Neil to do something on Broadway and in the films with some of those songs. And so I knew that was a reach, but I used the song as an inspiration, or I should say the album, to flesh out the idea I had for the story, which has nothing to do with Neil or his life or his storied career. So once I got the final that, hey, the songs aren't going to be available, I literally put it out to the universe, and starting with my incredible cast members, who are many of are singer-songwriters in their own right. And within 10 days, I had replaced 20 songs that, again, I used as an outline some of Neil's lesser-known songs, because the song, every song on this film, none of it is there because it's a cool song in the background and, you know, it's not a filler. Every song, every lyric, it propels the storyline and propels the character arc. And starting with Kimber Cleveland songs and Chester C. out of L.A., Chris McCarty, Doug Frazier, and I'm probably forgetting one or two other people, David Poe out of New York, I was blessed with literally 20 songs within 10 days, falling into the script, falling into the story I had in mind. And it just all happened. When things happen mystically like that, you just kind of roll with it. You get out of its way as much as you can. Like everybody said here, it's been a bumpy road. You know, independent filmmaking, you know, you make plans, God laughs. Well, that's kind of what happens with independent film. We wanted to shoot this in the spring, and there's been lots of stops and starts and reschedules. But everybody's been so passionate about it, both the sponsors that are involved that you'll see on the website, and especially this cast and crew. It's just been incredible that everybody stuck with it, and now we're on the eve of starting to roll cameras. So nice. It's been great.
Actually, too, we have another caller on the line. I want to say this should be Skippy.
So, oh, really?
Thank you, Christina.
Thank you very much, Christina, for calling.
Thanks, Chris.
Oh, wait, no, the person already hung up. So whoever was just calling, which I think is Skippy, call right back, and we'll get you going in the next 2 minutes.
All right.
I have one more question.
Oh, hey, that's awesome.
Oh, God.
A daily double. All right.
I was just wondering, does Danielle or Jay have any CDs currently out already that we could listen to their songs or voices? CDs available?
Oh, actually, yeah. I just self-released an EP called Landlady, and it's on iTunes. And it's kind of a different. Obviously, it has nothing to do with the film, but it is, and kind of a different genre. Kind of what I would do without this. But yeah, it's, you can listen to that. It's Landlady EP by Danielle White.
Awesome.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Well, you guys have a beautiful voice, and we can't wait to see the movie and hear you guys, and good luck with everything. And if you guys have an extra hour, bring it on. We love hearing about you guys. Sounds really neat.
That's cool. Well, you never know. You know, it's just Toad and I here.
Thank you
never
Christina.
Know what's going to happen. Thank you very much, Christina, for calling in. Appreciate it.
All right. Who do we have on the line here?
Gibby.
Skippy. Hey, Skippy.
Skippy,
what's going on, man? Happy birthday.
Hey, how's it going?
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Skippy. Thank you. I just figured I'd give a call in, see how things were going. I heard you guys had a really great guest today.
Yeah, we have Steve Tatone talking about a beautiful noise and the whole project. It's awesome. We're having an awesome time. Where in the galaxy are you, my friend?
If
you
can divulge secrets.
I was going to say if you can divulge any.
Watch out for giant black holes.
Yes.
Top secret. Yes, yes. Researching mega galactic black holes.
That's awesome.
So, yeah, thanks for coming on, Steve. Awesome that you guys were able to make it out. Just was wondering, was there some sort of a concert thing that was going on for Beautiful Noise?
Yes, it's been rescheduled. It was going to be in the third day of the original shoot date, which was August 26th. I'm glad you brought that up. Because of the scheduling and moving around some actor schedules and our schedules on our end, we've been forced to move the thing to the end of the shoot, and it's going to take place in the brand new Riverview Performing Arts Center, 1,000-seater out there at the new high school campus. We're excited about it. The new date will be announced in about a week. And,
all right.
So, yeah, glad you brought that up.
Where can people find that out if they're listening now? Where can they check that out in about a week to find out? And if you can let us know, we'll repeat it for sure on the air.
That's great. BeautifulNoiseTheMovie.com is the movie website. Right on the homepage in the top right-hand corner, there's a section they can click on and get all the updated news on the concert, which will be part of the film itself. It's the climactic piece of the film that Roger was talking about, where Jay sings Free Man in Paris in concert.
Very cool, very cool. Yeah, we'll definitely have to arrange for Skippy and the Dude to come on out and check that concert out.
Love to have you there.
That'd be nice to do a little on-location thing. That'd be awesome.
Yeah. That would be sweet.
And normally this would be the end of the show, but I think I'm going to go a couple extra minutes. I think they'll be okay with that.
Yeah, the moderators aren't monitoring chat right now, so we can keep going. We can keep going for a few extra minutes at least. Well, cool, man. You having a good time wherever you may be? Yeah?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Had a great birthday weekend. Have no complaints whatsoever. Spectacular time as should be had for a birthday, I think.
Definitely. Definitely, definitely.
Enjoy, man.
Well, cool. Enjoy yourself.
Yeah, you guys, too. Thanks for having such awesome guests and taking care of the show while I was gone, guys.
Oh, yes. Yes, we're reining it in your absence.
You did a great job.
I haven't hung up on anybody yet. So
I know. I was very surprised. Very surprised.
Try to switch you over.
I once hung up. All right, cool, guys. I'll talk to you later.
Have a good night. All right, cool. Well, like he said, the hour just went by. It's totally gone and mega fast. One more time, really fast, if anybody wants to pimp what they have going on or what we talked about, your EP that's released. Steve, anybody? Megan, say hi. We have it out there on the ether.
I just think the most important thing is a big thank you to everybody involved today. I think the sponsors, the businesses, the people. Locations, Jake's Tavern, the Cock and Bull Club out there on Cattle Show there, in Sarasota, Guitar Company, Richard's Computers. The embrace of the community is what's going to make it happen. And we're just so proud of the
gentlemen. It's
been our pleasure.
Yes. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Well, once again, we come to another end of the conclusion of Geekin Out with Skippy and the Dude. I'm the Dude, Skippy and called in. And who are you?
Nutto.
Have a good week, everybody. Bye.